let me just give you some insight. Okay, so this white kid, the ACT is a standardized test that you can either take the SAT or the ACT, right? So this white kid took the ACT. For sons, a good score on the ACT for sons is a 17, right? And that's what you need to make it to be eligible to play college sports, right? In order to play college sports to be eligible, you have to have a 17. And a lot of sons don't make that, so they have to go to junior college, right? Or they're academically ineligible. They changed the rule, right? Because it used to be higher than that. They changed the rule that, like, they had a thing called Proposition 48 back in the 80s. Because black kids had such a hard time meeting the requirements on the ACT test that they had to lower it. So it's basically the requirement to make it into college is a 17 on the ACT, which is basically like a baboon. You could sit a baboon, give them a pen, a pencil, and sit them in front of a test, and that baboon could just touch random fucking answers and get a 17 half the time, right? So this white kid got a 35, which is a very high score. I mean, that's an extremely high score. A 35 is a very, very high score. He has a 5.09 GPA. So that means he's taking all AP classes. So he got a very high score on the ACT on the standardized test, and he's taking all AP classes and getting A's. You have to take all AP classes and get straight A's to get a 5.09 GPA. This is him finding out which schools he got into. He applied to every Ivy League school.
Did I get into Harvard?
No.
Come on, just give me something, guys.
No.
Did I get in Columbia?
Dude, I must have done something serious.
And we see the type of kids that are getting into these Ivy League schools, right? The type of black and brown kids that are accepted to these Ivy League schools, man. Salute to Salute to 45 Revolver becoming a member, man. Shout out to you, man, becoming a channel member.
Did I get into Harvard?
No.
Come on, just give me something, guys.
No.
Did I get in Columbia?
Dude, I must have done something seriously wrong.
Did I get into Stanford University?
No! Yes, think I got into MIT.
I think we got it.
I did get rejected from MIT. Did I get into Duke University?
No.
I gotta get into one of these, dude. Did I get in to Rice University?
Wow, guys.
This tab was leaking my address. Oh, crap. Oh, shit.
Wow. So he didn't get into any of the good schools, man. But some black kid with a 22, like a 22 on your ACT is a high score for a black kid, right? There's a black kid somewhere with a 22 on the ACT and, you know, 3.5 GPA. At a shitty school like Martin Luther King Jr. Magnet School or some shit. Charter school somewhere, right? In some inner city. There's a black kid with a 22 on the ACT and a 3.5. That's going to get into every fucking one of those schools that he just listed. Press one. That'll get into everyone. And show up on campus and shit and with an attitude. And that black kid to show up on campus with an attitude, looking for microaggressions. Looking for microaggressions. Starting shit and shit, protesting and shit, and all this bullshit. Unfucking believable, man. Eddie Smith, man. He says, to the white racist parents of to the white racist parents of America, this is your child. You may not have given birth to him. Wow. 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 Salute to my boy Hawker, man. Hawker. Now I can drop the link, man. Shout out to Hawker, man. Getting us over the edge, man. Wow. Let me drop the link, man. You're all welcome to come up, man. Wow. Wow. Sun Man has no bound. The Sun Man, yikes. The Sun Man, wow. Wow. I ain't even gonna lie, man. Sometimes I think y'all can't shock me, but then y'all shock me, man. I think I seen everything, man. And then Sun's coming. Oh, man. To the white racist parents of America, this is your child. You may not have given birth to him, but he is yours. He is your racism. The other kids with him mocking that black woman are also yours. They are your racism. You taught them that. This is okay. This is on you. Fisherman, man, what do you think about that, man?
I mean, who cares? Who cares what sons think? Like, why does it, who, what group benefits has ever benefited from allying themselves with sons?
That's a man that wrote this, man. This wasn't a woman that wrote this, man. It's a lot here, man. Salute to a 45 revolver, man. The fact that, like, this guy can go to work tomorrow and just punch in and not, like, be holding his breath when he punches in, like, whether his code is still going to be working, man. Because, you know, somebody sent this to his boss. To the white racist parents of America, this is your child. And when he says white racist parents of America, you know he means all white parents. He means all of you. You may not have given birth to him, but he is yours. He is your racism. The other kids with him mocking that black woman are also yours. They are your racism. You taught them that this is okay. This is on you.
Can we apply this logic to all these Sun teams shooting everybody?
No, this guy would never tweet about any of that stuff. That stuff is so normal from black people for him that It's not even noteworthy.
Right. Well, can we apply it within this Ignatian bubble? Do you mind if we apply it?
Yeah, I don't mind. Yeah. This guy says, look at this guy. Show me something where she said anything racist, then get back to me. As if, like, we got to have, like, a 24-hour clock. Like, all we have is the video, which, like, we don't have, like, this isn't a reality show where cameras are following her. You're judging the entire of white America on a three seconds of this guy going, ooh, ooh, ooh. And his and he's requiring people to find something where the black girl says something racist. All we got is that same video you got, man. That's not life. That's just a 40-second view of an interaction between some people none of us know from an angle. Like, why do they act like, go find me something? She said, who is she? Who is she? Like, what the fuck are they talking about, man? It's just insane, man. So now white people are tasked to go find something in that 40-second video with 1,000 people yelling and screaming where this white woman said something racist. And if you did, think about it. If you found her saying all cave beasts need to die from torture, it still wouldn't matter.
Which she probably said, by the way. She probably said something to that effect.
Yeah, most doubt. I would love to see her. I would love to see her Facebook. I wish somebody would dox her. You know, this white people, this is the thing about white people. White people haven't doxed her. We don't know that girl's name. We don't know her Facebook. White people have not doxed her. He says, who gave parental advice? I only called out the racist parents who raised that little piece of shit and kids just like him. Are you one of those parents? Cope, motherfucker. Wow. They're not taking this. James Pearson Staples. He is a student at Ole Miss. He was making monkey noises at a black woman on the campus. His actions were praised by Representative Mike Collins, who said Ole Miss was taking care of business. So think about how fucked up this guy is. The representative posted the video not knowing that there were like that black, that they were gonna, you know, monkey noise. Who knows what monkey noises are, right? He reposted and says that the guy. So basically, he's saying the congressman reposted the video because the kid was making monkey noises. Not because this woman is a pro-Palestine supporter and she was harassing these people. The only reason people retweeted this video was because one of these guys made monkey noises for 3 seconds. And we all got to live in that reality with them. We all got to, nobody can say, hey, man, shut the fuck up. The fuck are you talking about? Everybody got to just act like that's the case. We're all bound by not even sun logic, sun gaslighting. Salute to IA. He says, that's hard to watch. All over Facebook, they have pics of black and brown students getting accepted into all the schools at the same time. LMAO. Yeah, man. Trust me, man. I seen it, man, with my own eyes.